Hello dear students, welcome to the lecture series of object oriented programming. In this lecture we are going to see the different approaches of operator overloading, and we will focus on overloading unary operators with an example. At the end of this lecture you will be able to construct a program for unary operator overloading. Operator overloading can be done by using three approaches. The first one is overloading unary operator. Then second one is overloading binary operator, and the third one is overloading binary operator using a friend function. Let us focus on how we can overload the unary operators. The unary operators operate on a single operand. The different examples of unary operator are increment operator, decrement operator, unary minus operator and logical not operator. Let us consider the example of unary minus operator. We know that this operator changes the sign of an operand when applied to a basic data variable. Let us see how to overload this operator so that it can be applied to an object which is the type, which is the variable of a type class, in much the same way as it is applied to an integer or a float variable. Unary operator appears on the left side of an object normally, such as not obj, minus obj and increment obj, but sometimes they can be used as a postfix, such as obj plus plus or obj minus minus, that is increment and decrement operator. Let us see the example of operator overloading. Here we will see the example of unary operator overloading. Now this is a class called as a space, which has these three data members as x, y and z. It has a member functions as get data, display and operator. Now please observe over here how this member function is declared. The return type followed by the operator. Now this operator is a keyword which is used for operator overloading, followed by the operator. Now here unary minus is the operator. We are not pass any parameter over here. Get data function is going to accept the values of a, b, c, that is 3 points from the user, and display function will display those values. Now when the unary minus operator will be applied on those three data members, that is a, b and c, that is x, y and z, then the sign of these three of the data members will get changed. Let us see how that operator function is defined over here. We have a operator function over here. Here the return type is given, followed by the name of a class, followed by scope resolution operator, followed by the operator, that is keyword, followed by the unary operator, that is a sign. If you observe over here, it is defined in the same way the member function is defined. Only the difference is here, instead of using the name of a member function, operator, the keyword is used for the operator overloading, followed by the operator. Now here when that unary minus operator is applied on three of the data members of the object, then the value of x will be changed, the value of y will be changed, and the value of z will be change. Okay, now let us see the main function. Here the object S is created of a space, and we have accepted the members, we have accepted the values of x, y and z as 10, minus 20 and 30 respectively. So when the unary minus operator is applied on those three values, 10, minus 20 and 30, the output should be reverse, that is the output should be, the value of 10 should be minus 10, the output of minus 20 should be, the value of minus 20 should be 20, and the value of 30 should be minus 30. Now I want to change the values of three of the data members which belongs to the object S. So what I will do, I will simply write minus S. S is the object and minus is my unary operator. So here this statement activates the operator function, and it will change the value of x, y, z respectively. Now here the value of x is 10, it will be minus 10, the value of y is minus 20, then after executing that operator function it will be 20, and the value of z is 30, and after executing that operator function, it will be minus 30. And if you want to display that values of x, y, z after overloading, then you can display those values using the display function. Now let us see what is the output. So initially the value of object x were the values of data members which belongs to object x were x is equal to 10, y is equal to minus 20 and z is equal to 30. And after executing the operator function, now which operator we have overloaded over here? We have overloaded minus operator, unary minus operator. So the value of x is minus 10, y is 20 and z is minus 30. So this is the way we can overload the unary operators in C++. So I hope you have understood how to overload the unary operators. Thank you. Happy learning.